love it.
Beauty and the Geek, 8:30 on Channel 7 tonight. This is a good laugh, this show. We're hanging out with the host of the show, Bernard Curry. You might know him from Home and Away as well. Hugo from our screens on Home and Away, and he joins us in the studio now. G'day, Bern. How
G'day,
you
G'day, kids. Thanks for having me. I'm really well, thanks.
Excellent, excellent.
Busy boy. I mean, doing Home and Away and the show. How do you manage both?
It's very tight. I had a very small production break from Home and Away to be able to then do Beauty and the Geek. Mm-hmm. We shot Beauty and the Geek in, like, you know, 4 weeks.
Come on, mate.
Episode in 4 weeks.
Are you allowed to tell us that?
You rocked up with one of the beauties this morning. Yeah. She's sitting out in reception. When you see her and meet her, you realise you make time. It doesn't matter how busy you are. You make time to work on this show.
It wasn't as tough as what everyone makes.
Yeah, it's not a hard gig for him.
It's in a great location too. Where is that house?
We shot it in Sydney, and it's a place called Dural out in Sydney, which is a fair way out, northwest Sydney. And it's all these huge tracts of land that have been bought up by these, you know, and then there's just these McMansions out there, huge places. Yeah.
Uh-huh. It's not the sort of show you'd expect a bit of controversy around, but there was a story in the paper, Stav noticed.
Yeah, this is making the rounds, you've even commented on it already, but one of the nerds, one of the geeks, has pulled the wool over the maker's eyes. And he's not as he's still a geek, but he's not as geeky as he made out.
Yeah.
He was. Is that correct?
Oh, that's what he's been labelled as. Look, a fake geek.
No. That's actually a beat up. Right. That kind of was a bit sort of a misrepresented story. Corin is one of those guys that you know you're not quite sure where he's coming from, but he is the 100% geek. I mean, like, he's a synthetic organic chemist, whatever that is.
Right, yeah.
I don't even know what that is.
Synthetic organic chemist, jeepers.
Apparently he is, what this means, because I'm no geek.
Right, okay.
Know.
Let's be perfectly clear about
let's
that.
Let's be perfectly clear. But he is he's Brigadier on Halo 3.
Oh, I know what that is.
Oh, you know what that is?
No,
yeah, right.
I have no idea what that is. And
our resident
so
geek.
he's won over 4,000 online games of Halo.
Wow.
So, I mean, he's
geeky.
The real deal.
That'd do
he
it.
Is,
what
he
I
is
like
geeky.
About that, he may have thought that wasn't geeky enough. God bless him. You know, he's like, I better geek it up or I'm not going to get on this show. You're like, nah, mate, you're all right.
Exactly. So, you know, of course he's going to say, look, I'm going to enter this show and I'm going to have a crack at it. Why not?
Yeah,
because he is the real deal. He is a geek.
And did you get along with all the beauties and the geeks, or did you have particular favourites? I mean, I know Michelle's sitting out there in a gorgeous gold costume.
Michelle is genuinely one of the most beautiful girls
The
show. On the inside as well.
Okay.
You know, she's obviously very aesthetically pleasing.
Yes.
And,
is there a good chance, like, any of these guys are actually going to hook up afterwards?
And look,
I want to see a geek hook up with a beauty. Come on.
I can
on.
Tell you that there is a definitely a bit of, mutual attraction going on within the show.
It's potential.
And there is one geek that gets his very first kiss.
Wow.
On national TV.
Oh, it'll be the Brisbane boy who we spoke to last week. The big fella?
Toby?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
No.
But I can tell you something about Toby, though. Toby is just one out of the box. He is hilarious. He's a great guy.
I love him.
And, you know, he sort of talks like this. He's all very proper very good. Yeah. And in tonight's episode, the geeks have to do speed dating. So they're going between woman to woman to woman, but not the beauties, another bunch of women. And he was telling me all about it. I said, how'd you go with your speed dating? He said, oh, it didn't go so well, Bernard. It was, they gave me the prep materials for, how to relate to a woman, how to have a date.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it says, when you sit down, you should open up with a line of some sort, a compliment or a joke. And here are a few examples, and I thought, I'll choose that one. That one looks quite good.
What was it?
Oh, no.
And he said, I was meant to say, sit down, and said, I think I must have died and gone to heaven because you look like an angel.
Oh, no.
And
that's classy pickup line.
Corny.
That's what he was meant to say. And he sat down and I got a bit flustered and I didn't quite know where I was going. And I said, I think I must have died because it smells like death.
Check, please.
Icebreaker. Oh, no.
Chick there going, this is speed dating. 2 minutes is way too long.
We are going to catch up with Queensland girl Michelle. She's 18. She's one of the beauties on the show. She is also a Gold Coast meter maid. There is an issue we need to talk about with her next that has hit the papers regarding her coming in this morning. And also we've got a bit of a challenge for her. Because we thought, you know, she's in the beauty department. We'll check out the brain side
of
things.
She's up for a challenge.
Okay, done. Great. Hey, mate, thanks so much for stopping by this morning. Congrats on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Home and Away going strong as well, which is always good.
Yeah, and also on Beauty and the Geek, you can actually win $7,000 apparently tonight by watching the show. So there's a hidden word in the show. You watch the show and you can win $7,000.
Sweet.
Excellent. Awesome. I love how you say apparently, like, you're not 100% true. You're just covering yourself
I
anyway.
I think.
Yep.
Can, yeah.
It is true.
Channel 7's up the mountain right now. Go, we're going to need $7,000, guys. Yeah. Pass the hat around. Beauty and the Geek. 8:30 tonight on Channel 7. We're catching up with one of the beauties next. I can see it coming. Still to come.